for changes. In 1776, this great nation accepted that armed conflict was the only way to preserve our rights to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. If our founding fathers could only see us now. From Antietam to Amiens, Okinawa to Anchorage,
we have fought. And now, the Red Menace is at our doorstep. Democracy itself is under threat of annihilation. That is why today, July 4th, 2076, 300 years after our great nation began, we gather together to honor the completion of Vault 76. This sprawling underground shelter may have been engineered by Vault Tech, but it was built by you, the good people of America, so that if the bombs do come, if the end does come, our way of life will endure. But not everyone will be saved. Those chosen to enter this vault must be our best and our brightest. For when the fighting is stopped and the fallout has settled, you must rebuild. Not just walls, not just buildings, but hearts and minds, and ultimately, America itself. So as we stand here today, we pray that the world will know peace. But if that is not our destiny, if war must come, we stand together knowing that here in Vault 76, our future begins.
Thank you. You have been tasked with nothing less than the rebuilding of America. Such a huge responsibility. Just know that Vault-Tec is proud of you. I am proud of you. When you hear this, it means I've been gone for several hours. I've got my own mission out there in Appalachia. This is the Overseer, signing off.
Message repeats in 24 hours.
System break down.
Your reclamation day.
I bet you're just bursting your bolts to get out there and see the world. Excellent. Adventure and opportunity awaits you, sir. The kiosks have valuable information to help you thrive out there. Best get cracking!
Oh, I do wish I could come with you. But someone's got to man the fort, as it were. If you find any other functioning Mr. Handy units out there, do send my regards. Imagine dying of hunger or thirst. Oh, that would be embarrassing. Medicine checklist. Radex, Radaway, Stimpak. Got it? Good. Power grid and making your own electricity. How hard could it be? When you get outside, find each other. Seek strength in numbers. Utilize both your similarities and differences.
Do remember the whole point of Reclamation Day?
Reclaiming Appalachia?
Never too late.
To be anything. Cook, assassin, medic, hacker, bullet sponge. So wonderful, the human condition.
There they are! Vault 76's own Rip Van Winkle!
How many months has it been?
Overseer's log, or should I say, direct communication. Because whoever is listening to this had the moxie to try to find out where I've gone. But I'm glad you did. Truth is, I need your help. I've been given a task and I've decided to break protocol and tell you what it is. Because if there's one thing I've learned in these past few years, it's that we need to rely on each other. There were three active nuclear silos in Appalachia before the bombs fell. They blew up the world before. We can't let it happen again. So we've got to locate and secure all of the silos. Or die trying. Hopefully the former. But it's been 25 years. I just don't know what we're gonna find out there. Or where to start. My directive was to go to the nearest population center and assess the situation. I'll set up a camp on the way once I get my bearings. Find me there.
Survival and rebuilding, so use it often. Outside, survival will be easy with your construction and assembly mobile platform, or out. So catchy.
Is today the day? Leaving the vault at last? The Overseer could be anywhere by now.
Au revoir.
Sir, those young ladies down there, they seem exceedingly alive. They haven't yet made any untoward advances, but perhaps you could speak to them? Verify their intentions are civil? Only that they appear to have some vested interest in accessing the vault. One seemed quite perturbed when I told them that wouldn't be happening. But I'm not sure if she believed me. I've been keeping watch here long enough to have learned that outside the vault, people don't always have one's best intentions at heart. I'm sorry to say it, but it's the truth. Until quite recently, it's been exceedingly peaceful. I maintained my post, greeted latecomers out of the vault, and otherwise reveled in Appalachia's natural splendor. But very recently, it seems people have come back to Appalachia. Those two and more to boot. The non-vault sort, you understand. It's all very concerning. Who knows what they might be up to? Well, yes, but it's been some time. But she was a resourceful woman. I'm sure she's all right. Oh, do be careful out there, sir.
There's got to be a way in there. Maybe.
Wait, a vault dweller?
Hey there! Whoa, whoa! Just a friend here, not a threat. Just had some questions for you.
You came out of the vault, right?
I thought it was empty. Wait, is the door still open? Son of a bitch, we missed our chance. We really needed that.
We got a tip from the Wayward. Heard of the place? New bar down the road.
So this guy told us that...
After you gave him the last of our caps?
And he said that inside that vault is the... You know, that's where the big one is.
Our last chance to turn our lousy luck around. Wait, what?
Aypeneja, he's jerking you around, Lacey. Face it. We got scammed.
Those were the last of our caps. No. Someone has to know something. We're just gonna stick it out until we find them.
Wonderful.
Look, thanks for whatever. Now, unless there was something you needed. I certainly could, but since you decided to yank our chains, I'm gonna say no. Mm-hmm. Bye.
objection. These babies are chewable. It's a straight line from pill to progress.
That's all I needed to hear, Bill. The Junior Vault Security Patrol has been waiting a long time to find out who's been peddling these poisons. Your game is over.
Cut ourselves free from America to rebuild America. Take the old...
Protect and serve.
Frederick was your average all-American nuclear roboticist.
Keep fighting out there.
Looking for solutions.
Well, QX-57.
Fort Atlas is in good hands. Night Shin's trained as well. Order.
Looking for
running,
advancements.
95 days on a single fusion core is good.
We used to make these things fly all night.
But how can we make it better?
Well,
looking
I'll understand one day.
Love.
Never forget the heroes of Fort Defiance.
QX-57. While I'm happy to dedicate my life to serving the old red, white, and blue, I feel like I've missed my chance to meet
This is
someone.
A restricted area, Savannah.
What do you mean? I already have.
This Valentine's Day, find out what happens when artificial intelligence leads to real feelings.
I can't. You're a two-ton weapon of mass destruction, and I'm just a human. You're right. I am a man. A man with the need for love.
Can a robot capable of white-hot lead also create red-hot relations? Find out in Weapon of Mass Attraction, launching soon at a theater near you.
From our sponsors.
Mortimer, where did you find this classic Ming vase? Surely you asked the museum for permission.
Oh, Vanessa. First of all, it's not Ming. I would appreciate if you didn't call me a communist. Second, I didn't purchase it from the museum.
Really? Was it at the gallery in Soho?
Getting colder.
The Bohemian Art Show in France.
You're freezing. Why, at this rate, I'm going to have to ask Mr. Hamby to turn on the furnace.
Well, you have to tell me. I simply must know.
I bought it at Appalachian Antiques.
Wait. You mean to tell me there's a store selling the finest in collectible antiquities right here in West Virginia?
That's correct. It's just up the road, north of Fort Defiance. Art and antiques at prices only a true Wotoban can afford.
I wouldn't want to run into
anything
on the way.
Nor would I, Vanessa.
Oh. Appalachian Antiques. The finest goods and antiquities for sale, but never off.
My job, Park Guest Brian. No, you can just call me sometimes. They try and steal the guest's food.
Okay, so how close do you get to
Cappy's treehouse? It has a maze, an elevator to the top with a view of the whole park.
Hey, do treehouses have safety railings?
I'm so excited to help and guide you today, park guest Brian. Come on down to Nuka World and see it for yourself!
The crowd is impassive. What could it be? Just then, as Todd and park guest Brian enter the Safari Adventure Zone, trouble strikes. A bird swoops back, just missing our hero's head. The animals are loose and roaming free among the guests. This cannot be good for Nuka World. Security guard Marco approaches our heroes.
Please, leave the area immediately. Yes, sir. It's true. The animals are loose. Over. Not sure at the moment, but I'm investigating, sir. Over. Yes, sir. We've located the lions and tigers, but not the bears. Over.
Ow! There they are, Marco! Over there, by the Nuka Blasters!
I don't think there's honey on their pot.
It's probably barbecue sauce. Bears love anything sweet and sticky. Little trivia for you.
I've located the bears, sir. By the bottle blasters. They're drinking barbecue sauce. They seem very content. Over. Good idea, sir. I'll get more barbecue sauce to keep them subdued. Over. Hey, Charlie, nice spot with the bears. Say, what's your friend's name?
Brian.
I'm Marco, the security guard. Nice to meet you, park guest Brian.
You can call me...
How'd you know that about bears, Charlie?
Oh, I love animals. I know all sorts of facts. Did you know frogs have 360-degree vision?
I could use 360 vision right about now.
You seem to know a lot about animals. Think you could help me out?
Oh, boy. Yes! Nothing dangerous, I hope?
Yeah, a few geckos are lost, some lizards. The crocs are safe and locked up. Oh, the anaconda is loose.
Oh, snakes! Why is this happening?
Sabotage, park guest Brian. Sabotage. The Bib Company is always trying to show Nuka up. They're jealous and hate that Nuka Cola is the best damn soda, period. It's sabotage, and I can't stand it! I just know Vim is behind it!
That's awful! We need to stop it! I love Nuka Cola, so I'll help out!
Fantastic! I'll order more barbecue sauce for the bears, and we'll head to the reptile house to see what we can find.
So exciting! We can help Nuka World see animals up close and save the day! Or be lunch! Wait, that's a great point. Marco, do you know when the anaconda was last fed?
Oh, we do. What?
Oh, it's due to be fed. That means it's hungry and looking for food.
Best move fast. I don't want any more incidents.
Any
more? Don't worry, park guest Brian. We are a park with every minimum acceptable safety standard.
Snakes love warmth and heat. Where is the hottest area of Safari Adventure Zone?
Reptile House.
I'll bet it never left. Let's go! I'll lead the way!
Our heroes enter the reptile house with nothing more than a torch and Charlie's knowledge of snakes to guide them. What awaits inside?
Careful where you stand. It's hard to see. I think we need to lure the anaconda back into its exhibit.
Good plan.
Oh, I'm guessing it doesn't eat empty lead snack cake?
No. It eats red.
I need to get downtown to look at I need to see.
Just then, Park guest Brian accidentally spits on the snake's tail.
You killed it, Parker!
saves the day by returning all the creatures to their cages. However, the saboteur from Vim is still on the loose. Will the Vim Vader be caught? Who is the Vim Vader? Will park guest Ryan wake up? Until next time on Tales from Nuka World. Stay tuned.
Ago, saw the world stand together to fight against the slimening. But what happens when the world needs the slime?
Let's get one thing straight, slime. I don't like you. You killed my wife. But damn it, you're the best bet we have at getting those nuclear codes back. Apologies mean little from the likes of you. Teach those commies a lesson about personal property, and then we'll talk.
This summer, it's slime to infiltrate. It's slime to love.
Why did you rescue me? I'm not your main objective. But maybe after this is done, I can.
It's slime to die. The chartreuse slime to
chop
slime
chop
to die.
Blood, chop.
Theaters
everywhere, let's go on! Gee whiz, Susie. The night sky sure is beautiful up here on Lookout Point. Not nearly as beautiful as you are, though.
Oh, Tommy, you're the sweetest. It's a little chilly tonight, but the view is breathtaking.
Here, let me warm you up a bit.
Did you hear that? I think someone is out there.
No way. It's your imagination. Now, where were we?
Oh, no! Susie!
Tommy, save me!
Young man, this is preposterous. I refuse to believe that a giant bug destroyed your car and kidnapped your girlfriend. Now, if you're done wasting my time, I have actual crimes to prevent. Huh. Giant bugs? Preposterous.
But it's the guy on the chute, Sheriff. You have to believe me. A gigantic insect did kidnap Susie. It was the size of a bus, and there are more than one. Those things are everywhere. You have to save her.
That's enough out of you. Deputy, escort this chem addict out of here immediately.
Stand a chance with you on the job.
Stop! You have to listen to me. Big bugs, ants, spiders, cockroaches. Those bugs are not normal bugs!
Mother of God! What? What are those?
Humanity is threatened with annihilation by those born from the unnatural union of nature and radioactive fire. Creatures so terrifying that words cannot describe the horror those macabre, mutated menaces will bring. Those coming to a theater near you this summer.
Projectron works all night and also works all day.
Chapter 4 of Heart of Steel, A Dread Island Tale. 7 days after their marooning, we find our trinity of wayward castaways making their way through the little explored northern region of the island. The need for fresh food has driven them ever further in their expeditions, and as luck would have it, they found a shallow pond teeming with bright fish.
Want to the weather lose was warm, lumberjack
and the wind was mild.
Gee,
although young Anna had grown seasoned and wise enough to know that fine weather meant little for a fine day on Dread Island.
Hark! Great job finding this place. Look at all these fish. We can hang them up at camp dry and we'll eat well for days.
Anna, it does appear safe, but we must be careful. We cannot grow complacent on this island.
Well, we've got you to look out, so
trees are the enemy.
What?
Must eliminate trees.
Yeah, some jokes, Hart.
Never trust atoms. They make up everything.
Tell us another, Hart.
Doctor, there's a patient online one that says he's invisible. Well, tell him I can't see him right now.
You sure got some good ones, Hart.
Franklin, children, my sensors are picking up an energy signal in the vicinity. It appears harmless, but I cannot determine its location.
Testing, testing. This is Grafton Fair. Our lovely valley is in a bit of a pinch. Think crab claws.
Following the robot sensor readings. Through hanging leaves and twisting vines they search, Hart's machinery carefully tracking the unknown signature. After a time,
hello.
The thick vegetation
here. Why, you have the look of a promise.
Hart and the children find themselves at the threshold of a large entranceway leading deep into the cliff. A trapezoidal doorway twice as tall as a man. Set into the sides of the cliff are strange devices, each containing a large, flat disc of a strange material and fastened on a swiveling mount.
Look at those things! Wow, Hart! Who could have built something like this?
Time your scout uniform.
And that's
keep it clean and wear it with pride. Now go forth, my little tadpole, and get to work on those badges with diligence and determination. You'll be a possum in no time.
Emilio, wait! Don't touch anything!
Before he stops, Emilio has pushed on the nearest of the odd metal devices along the side of the doorway. It spins far more easily than its ancient appearance would suggest. Upon coming to the end of its spin, the disc catches the beams of the bright afternoon sun. Anna's eyes stare in amazement as the beam jumps down the hallway, illuminating it as bright as moonlight. As the sunbeam travels, it meets similar attached fixtures down the hall and fills the entire structure with light, bouncing from disc to disc.
Well now, isn't that something, Hart? Oh, Father would have loved to see such clever engineering.
Well, I'm the one who figured it out, Anna.
Correct, Emilio. However, I recommend increased discretion. Anna, the source of the signal is close. My sensors have determined we could potentially use this energy to recharge my power cells.
All right, well, we're going to take off.
Carefully, they follow the strangely angled hallway deep into the unknown. Finally, the long hall comes to an end. The center disc revealing a large circular rotunda. Dust swirls in the air, lit by the reflected sunbeams. In the center of the room, where the shafts of light converge, stands a strange stone pedestal and a vibrant cut jewel, deep blue in color. The size of a lady's slipper, it sits splendidly on top of the pedestal, wrapped in intricate bindings of metal and curiously cut stone.
Goodness, that jewel is beautiful, isn't it? Have you ever seen one like it?
Thank you. Your mother and father must be so proud to see you in that uniform. If I was your mother, I know I would be proud. You must be the new tadpole. It's always nice to meet a new pioneer. I love nature, don't you? Pioneer scouts love all of nature, even the smelly skunks and ugly opossums. Can you say opossum? Good. One thing all the boys and girls in Pioneer Scouting hate is toxic mutagenic waste. Can you say toxic mutagenic waste? It's yucky stuff. Pioneer Scouts used to pick up trash to earn a badge. That's pretty futile now. Can you say futile? I knew you could. You can earn a badge by cleaning up nasty old toxic mutagenic waste and putting it in a containment barrel. Can you say containment barrel? I knew you could. Now run along and earn that badge.
Toxic mutagenic waste may cause spurious genetic modifications, some of which may be harmful or even fatal.
That badge won't earn itself.